Asian carp, or copi, as they've been recently renamed, continue to be a growing problem in Illinois. States trying to get creative in stopping the invasive species before they reach the Great Lakes and destroy the ecosystem.
WGN's Kelly Davis tells us about a special technique called electrofishing and shows us how it's done.
One by one.
There's one. There they are.
Dozens of fish fly out of the water.
That guy's huge.
These big fish are famous for damaging boats, breaking equipment, even injuring people. Fortunately, none of that happened today, but we did get an up-close look at this invasive species.
These are the silver carp, the ones that we hear about jumping all the time.
Nick Barkowski is a fish biologist with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers.
Yeah, it's real shallow.
He's been tracking the invasion of Asian carp for 14 years.
If we can increase that catch down there, decrease the risk of passage upstream.
Asian carp have taken Illinois waterways by storm. They were used by fish farmers to control algae in the 70s, and their numbers exploded in the early 2000s. The invasive species are a serious threat to the Great Lakes and could destroy our ecosystem. Carp populations grow at a rapid rate, and all they're eating reduces the amount of food for other fish.
Now you have competition. You have a lot of these invasive fish species that are eating the same things that our native fish species are eating, and you can start having some imbalance within the ecosystem.
States are spending millions of dollars to control the problem and are trying to get creative. Just last month, the Illinois Department of Natural Resources renamed the fish copi in hopes of making it more appealing to people.
A lot of people haven't eaten it or cooked it, but it's a beautiful fish.
Fish biologists are on board, saying it's a great campaign.
It's just getting it out there and getting people past this mindset of, oh, it's a carp, it's a nasty fish. But it's not. It's really not.
Until people start eating a copious amount of copi, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers are keeping their eyes on the water.
Go ahead, swing those arms around.
They're sticking to their tried and true method of electrofishing. Here's how it works. Those arms pump electricity out into the water, creating a current in front of the boat.
You want to sneak up on them and then hit it right at the last second.
It temporarily stuns the fish so they float to the surface and are quickly caught.
That allows us to effectively see the fish, net them, count them, and it's rapid and quick.
But not necessarily easy.
Oh, these are heavy.
The 10 plus pound fish are netted and dumped into a live well.
I didn't expect this to be the hardest part.
By the end of the day, we got the hang of it and netted nearly two dozen fish.
The intent is to eradicate them forever, but I don't, realistically, I'm not sure that will ever be the case with the numbers that are here.
Since 2010, the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers have pulled up more than 11 million pounds of Asian carp just out of the Illinois River.
There we go.
At this point, they say it's a matter of controlling the population.
It's a huge group effort where we're all doing a bunch of different things. Several of us are electrofishing, some are pulling fish from the water. What we do with the Corps of Engineers is a small part of the overall picture.
All the fish we caught were harvested, but electrofishing is also used to tag Asian carp and track them. That helps experts pinpoint locations that are heavily populated, and then contracted fishermen can go in and extract them. I'm Kelly Davis, WGN News.